Hello everyone, this is the 100x Zoom channel. Today I have this small binocular, so you can understand how small it is. For example, here is the BPS-4. Do you see? Here is the BPS-4. And this is Hilkinson, made in Japan, fully coated. Full multi-coating 30x80. 30 is not the diameter of the objective lens, 30 is the magnification, and 80 is the diameter of the objective lens. Take a look. This binocular can be classified as an astronomical binocular, that is to say, it is large and can be mounted on a tripod. It is preferable that this binocular does not have a double vision, then it is possible to observe the moon or some other celestial bodies. Its field of view is only 2 degrees. Well, that is quite small. To help you understand, at a distance of 1 kilometer, this is approximately 35 meters. Therefore, the field of view here is small. Now, I will disassemble it a bit. The objectives need to be unscrewed and cleaned. Next, there is a prism block and 2 prisms. Well, then it needs to be cleaned again because it has some kind of haze. After that, I don't know, maybe. I'll show you a bit of what's inside it. I don't think there's anything particularly special in there. And then, as usual, we'll take some pictures. And I also want to add, so you understand, its weight is 2300 grams. That is 2 kilograms, 300 grams. Well, I can tell you, it is not light.
The binoculars are almost disassembled. There is an anti-fog cap. Here are the prisms. What else is there but BK7? Here is a lens, I must say. It is quite large and heavy. Well, it seems like that's it. Now I just need to clean it up. And for everything, I will blacken the edge of this lens. I definitely don't think it will be a problem. As you can see, I cleaned the prisms, but I didn't blacken them. It's a very tedious task and takes a lot of time. I blackened the lenses. Here is one, and the second one is already assembled. I don't know how much the blackening effect will add, but maybe I will keep this binoculars for myself, or maybe I will sell it. I don't know.
There are no adjustment rings on the objectives. Everything is adjusted using a prism. These are the lenses. 5 lenses in 3 groups. All of them are coated. And all of them are made of glass. Well then, let's take a look. If any of you want to ask whether the binocular performs well, yes, the binocular performs quite well at 30 times. It is practically impossible to look through this binocular handheld. It needs to be mounted on a tripod. Well now, besides the fact that it has a big advantage, which is the 30x magnification, I will talk about its drawbacks. It has everything you could want. It grinds at the edges quite strongly. Chromatism is also present in it, and the closer it is to the edge, the more noticeable it becomes. Distortion is also quite strong in it. You see, those cables are almost in the center, a little to the right, and they are already bending. The road is 2 kilometers away. As you can see, objects can be discerned, meaning that magnification allows you to notice some, I don't know, lighting on the surfaces. But reading any information that is written, for example, on the trailer, is already difficult or even impossible. A few more words about the image quality. In fact, when you look with your eyes, it is somewhat better. The phone deteriorates the image, it amplifies distortion and spherical aberration. But still, the image quality is not the same as in CES, not the same as in modern ones. For example, SV Boney. Here, the binoculars are about 50 years old. So this is approximately the kind of image you can expect.
To use these binoculars more or less comfortably, you must meet two conditions. The first is to use the binoculars on a tripod. The second condition is to use it during bright, sunny times of the day. Thank you all for watching the video, and see you next time.